comedian, and let's welcome the comedy stylings of Neil McGarry. All right, local boy, tell him.
People always say that to me. I gotta be honest with you guys. You ever have one of those days where the odor of what you were drinking last night is kind of oozing out of your pores? I'm having one of those days now. So if you guys in the front smell yoo-hoo, I don't know what that's about. So I'm so excited this has a comedy category. Because, you know, a lot of the clubs aren't really friendly to gay people. You know, they only want you on stage if you're doing that, you know,
yeah, so I told my girlfriend up your ass thing.
And that's not going to work for me unless the girlfriend is named Brad. And it might not be that bad if I was one of that 10% of gay guys who sounded like Barry White. But instead, I kind of came out more like Betty White. But it's tough to get on stage if you're, you know, a gay guy. Because a lot of the clubs aren't going to let you near the stage unless you're doing somebody's hair. Because that's what we're good at, right? All gay people, we all do hair. I'm not good at most typical gay things. So, I mean, I've got the fucking guy's part down cold. Way cold. But I can't do your hair, and I can't do your makeup, I can't do your interior design. But I can do your brother. Assuming he's of age, don't get excited. I remember I was on stage one time at this club. The crowd was this like angry, straight, white guy crowd. And first of all, before I go on, what the hell do straight white guys have to be angry about? I mean, let's review this, right? They have an easier time landing a job than black people. They earn more money than women. And if they're Republican, they can fuck gay guys and still vote against same-sex marriage. So I don't want to hear any complaints from them. Anyway, so I'm in front of this angry crowd, and in the middle of my set, one of the pressure tricked me up and he says,
"Dude, are you gay?"
So I'm kind of, you know, like I'm doing this, I'm kind of frozen in time. So I'm like, well, I'm not sucking cock right this moment. And, you know, that's difficult because, you know, he's kind of just putting me in a box, right? Because I'm not just gay. You know, I'm also unemployed. So, guys, if I'm cruising it in the restroom, I'm really just trying to give you a resume. Or steal your wallet. But, you know, when you categorize people, it's kind of, you know, you're kind of like using differences to divide people, aren't you? And it's easy to divide people, you know, at the national level, state, by race, even in this room right now. There are divisions. Because, you know, I'm a stand-up comedian, and you guys have jobs that pay. But, you know, I think that no matter how hard you try, you can always find things that bring together a common ground. You know, for example, are there any straight guys here? Okay. Straight guys. You know, straight guys, their greatest fear is marrying a woman. Mine too. Brings us right together. So who's the straight girls here? Straight women. You think that the primary purpose of straight men is to fix cars and dance naked in cages for our amusement. Me too. You just heard the balcony here? I have to tell you, is somebody going to dump a bucket of blood on me? And they're all going to laugh at me. So what else brings us together? Oh, I know. Text messaging brings us together. Well, it sure, but I gotta tell you, I'm not good at text messaging, because, first of all, my cell phone is so old, it's still like a rotary dial. And I'm not good at typing with my phone. So, like, all my texts come out like, running, late, be there, spoon, cute. Do you guys text message? Are you texting right now? He's like, can't talk listening to this you-hoo motherfucker. My name is Neil McGarry. You guys have been great. Woo!